goes to college.
Also, what kind of college he'll wind up attending.
Whether he'll receive a scholarship or financial aid.
Then, of course, there are those dreaded SATs. I think that's really the big test for the kids.
What else do college admissions officers have to go on but high school grades and SAT scores?
But then you go past that. You're in college. And those grades will determine what kind of jobs will be available to you after graduation.
And it all comes back to marks on tests. And that's where memory training can make a huge difference.
When I go in to take a test, and I'll be like, haha, you don't have an advantage. You know, I know things you don't know.
I wish that I would have taken this course before I went through high school and college. If I would have had this for midterms and finals, I would have aced my courses.
Math was, it became a lot easier. And just in general, my grades improved drastically.
It feels like you know a little secret and no one else knows. And you're thinking to yourself, these poor guys are knocking themselves out over here. They're pulling out their hair, even writing cheat sheets. And your own little cheat sheets in your mind, all you gotta do is put it on paper.
Okay, memory techniques make testing easier. But do they make studying easier as well?
Yes. Remember how we recalled that grocery list?
Yeah, I can still see some of the groceries all over me.
Kids can apply similar techniques to anything. Math, science, English, history, even languages. There's no drudgery to it. And with the memory techniques, Alex, they really learn the material, not just for the quiz, but for good.
So no more late nights, head throbbing, yellow highlighting, things like that?
No more parental threats and bribes. Our students enjoy studying, and they look forward to taking the tests.
I memorized a lot of things for school because you have to pass the test. But now when I think back, I can't really remember what it was I remembered. If I would have taken the memory course first, the things I would have remembered would still be with me now. And that's saying something because it's been 3.5 years since I've been in school.
We had this teacher that made us memorize the preamble. The way they did it is they had to just say it over in their head, over and over. We the people, we the people. And all I had to do was just say it over once.
I remember the different, there's techniques in math, you know, how to solve problems, different solving problems in math, and those just came through my head really easy. And I just flew through math.
I don't have to write things down anymore. Before I wrote things down and I looked them over and over and over, and it would not go in my brain. Now, I don't have to write it down. It's already there.
That's what this memory thing is all about. You want to be tested. Test me. Test me now. I am good. I can remember. So if I am good and if I can remember, I am going to be better. And so the kids will be better. When they go to take a test, they're scared. They're scared. The way the memory course kind of sits them is that it's a fun game way to learn. And I know, I absolutely know that a child would look forward to taking a test. He wants to be tested. He has memory. He has recall. And he would like to show you by taking your test.
Well, that's fabulous. No more dreading the test. Now it's test me. I want to show you how good I am, right?
It's a whole turnaround in attitude towards school and themselves. Kids now know they're going to excel on tests. They'll be complimented. Other kids in school will look up to them. Their parents will be proud of them. So their self-esteem, their confidence goes way up. And so do their aspirations. Maybe I can be a doctor after all, or whatever they want to be. And the ironic thing about it is, this is something they didn't learn in school.
I think it helped Javier to not be frustrated with all the things that he had to learn, memorize. You know, it just helped him so that he just handled it much better.
He's able to do it, and I think that makes him a stronger individual.
Well, my daughter Carrie is 15 years old. She's going into the 10th grade, and this is the first time in a couple years that she's been excited for school. It was always, when school was started, it was, oh no, now what am I going to do? And I don't want to go to school. And she's getting excited. She watches, reads her tapes, or listens to her tapes, and reads the material for memory dynamics. And she's excited about school. And that makes us excited.
You know, in other countries, they really stress education more and more and more and more and more. Here, it's up to the parents to really stress it. And it's a way of life in other countries. Here, it's not.
And that's why, and here's some good news for all of you out there, that's why you developed the Memory Dynamics Home Course.
Exactly.
Okay.
I want you to meet somebody, a graduate of our course. He's a very concerned and innovative educator in our home city, and he's planning to use our course in his school as a teaching aid. His name is Dr. Bernard Hamilton, and he's standing by now.
All right, Dr. Hamilton, Alex Trebek here. Can you hear me?
Sure.
Dr. Hamilton, they've mentioned that you plan to use the course in your school. How would you do that?
I'm starting a parent center to help teach parenting skills. And the purpose of that, of course, is to help the teachers and the parents to help the students. And one of the things I want them to do is I want them to either take the class or view the video in the parent center so they can practice these skills so they can help their boy or their girl.
Well, we applaud you on that one, Dr. Hamilton, because I think it's a great idea to involve the parents in the educational process, especially right there in the school.
Most educators and the public have a tendency to down-bash parents. If the parents would do their part, everything would be okay. Well, we're the experts, and I believe we need to have strategies for parents to help them do their part. And this is just one strategy that I'm going to use in our school to help them with kids' homework and with learning.
Are you saying that the memory dynamics course is an important aid to learning?
I think the course has a legitimate value from an educator's point of view in providing guarantees to learning. I think a secondary guarantee is that you can bring the grades up.
To you as an educator, what's the bottom line benefit?
The fact that there's components in that course that I can use for my parents, for my students, and for my teachers, and they can use for each other, gives me one more tool, one more strategy that I can use to guarantee student achievement. And that's what we're all about at Walter Bracken School, guaranteeing student achievement.
Well, Doctor, we commend you and we thank you. Oh, one last question, if I may. How would you grade Dave Coffill as a teacher?
If I gave David Coffill a report card, I would probably simply say that he's one of the outstanding teachers.
Well, all right. Dave, you get an A. Congratulations. Now let's move on to a new subject. How an improved memory can lead to greater income in business.
Alex, it's key to every aspect of business, isn't it? For instance, knowing and remembering what you need to know about your client or prospect, it tells him that you care about him, that he's important to you as a person.
I've had more than one case. Actually, one real good one that I can think of, because it was the biggest deal that I've ever done, was a referral from a client who was so impressed with me because they thought that I really cared about them. The reason they thought I cared about them is because they told me their name and a little story about them. And the next time I saw them, I relayed the story and their name and the situation and the time. And 2 days later, they sent me their accountant who bought 4 houses from me.
The other salesmen here, they see me sell 20, 30 cars a month. And they just think I'm lucky, but really it's skill that does it. And part of the skill is being able to remember who you talk to and what they're buying.
I was out at the airport catching a flight to Chicago, and as I was racing down the runway, I ran into one of our investment banking clients, John Simonelli from Oklahoma City. And I hadn't seen John for probably about a year, and instantaneously remembered his name, chatted with him, and arranged some further business activity with him all at the same time.
What about moving up the company ladder?
Well, you've always got to be on top of things, don't you, Alex? Being buttoned up in presentations, handling those left field questions, having all the facts, the complete picture, in the front of your mind instead of back on your desk.
Just like I would go to my filing cabinet and pull out a file that I hadn't seen for a year, I'm now able to pull out the information from my mind, from my memory, and use it.
The consequences of remembering the little piece of information is that my life is much easier. People have more confidence in me because when they tell me something, they know what's going to be followed through with. They know it.
I seem to know more now than I did, and I remember things a lot better. When people have questions around here, everybody says, ask Trish. Trish will know.
And in all honesty, it's more impressive to other people, too. Subordinates that report to you and whatever, they feel a whole lot more confident in your abilities and whatever when you can retrieve it from your mind rather than saying, I'll call you back or I'll get back with you or whatever else.
The one with the answers is the one who gets the promotion and the raise.
So you see, ladies and gentlemen, what you don't know can hurt you. Dave, the word confidence keeps coming up over and over again. Is that the bottom line for us here?
It's all one big bottom line, isn't it, Alex? When you can remember what you need to remember, you do better at school, so you feel better about yourself. So you do even better at school or at work.
We'll be right back.
This course makes you able to be more personal, more professional. It makes it easy for you to remember things. And how do you put a price on that?
And that can be one of the most gratifying things that you can do for your kids, period, the end.